you have got the Piranha 140 on the Icebear Champion. No longer 125, now Icebear 140. It was an easy swap. It's like I have to relearn wheelies all over again. But this is the Piranha 140. Gonna have to upgrade that carburetor. That carburetor does seem a little too small for it, so doesn't weigh any bigger than the stock engine, so it's pretty much the same as far as weight. But yeah, I'm gonna enjoy this. What's up, YouTube? We are back with the CT, except we have a Piranha 140 installed, guys. Last video, I definitely told you guys that I wanted a 140. I had a blast with the group ride, but there was another CT there that just definitely convinced me that I wanted a 140. We're gonna definitely test this thing out, man. Hope you guys like what I've done with the bike so far. The swap was a very easy swap. There was nothing difficult about it, nothing to do other than literally take the old engine out, put this engine in, wire it in color by color, bam, started it right up. The guy gave me a clutch lever with it, so it's no longer semi. We got us a manual going on. So basically this video, guys, we're just gonna be test riding, man. It's a lot more power. The thing is riding perfectly fine. I'm gonna want more power, of course, so I'm gonna go with a bigger carburetor soon. But until then, everything is stock on this engine. And yeah, man, we're gonna test this thing out and see how it actually rolls. Let's go. What is up, YouTube? We're back. And like I promised from the last video, we have a 140 in the CT, man. And I have to say, I love it. I have the exhaust wrap on now, so no more leg burns. Thank God. This was a very easy swap, guys. Pretty much matched up the wiring. Two bolts to take the old engine off, two bolts to put this engine on. Pretty much the carburetor that I have on it now came already tuned. I have a VM26 genuine Makuni on its way, should be here tomorrow. I'm gonna put that on and see how it rides. I heard that is a big performance gain on these 140s, and also I've tried wheeling it a couple times and it usually gives me a loss of power within my wheelie, so I'm 100% accurate. The other carburetor will fix that. As far as how this thing performs, man, you guys are seeing it now. It feels just like the 125. Of course, this is a manual, though. You see I added a clutch to it. Neutral is all the way down. And all the rest are up, of course. Like I said, man, it feels like the 125, just with a lot more torque, a little more power within the band. That was a little second gear wheelie right there. This thing is rolling way better. Way, way better than my last engine, the 125 stock engine, which I will admit, guys, the stock engine that come on these Icebears, it's a good engine. Like, literally, it's a good engine. I can't say anything wrong with it. I've had a couple Liffins, I've had a Grom clone before, and out of all those engines, I would say that engine and the Liffin engines are exactly the same. And to be in fact, that engine is a Liffin. I don't know if you guys noticed, but those speed bumps didn't used to be there. Word is they added them because of the mini bikes. I'm not sure
Neither do I care. Let's try to hit a couple willies really quick before I go get some gas. Woo. I like that. I like that. I like that a lot. As you guys can see, this thing does willy just like the 125, which you guys shouldn't be surprised. The speed, man, the speed on this thing feels so much better and smooth, like it accelerates. To be honest, this is what I should have got on my Grom clone versus that 190. Gonna pop a couple more willies. It is so much funner with the 140, man. If you guys want to stunt any CT, I'm almost feeling like any bike, man, the 140. It literally, this is the first bike I've ever ridden a wheelie in fourth gear. And man, it excites me. We're gonna stop here and get some gas really quick, man. I'm just toying around right now, letting you guys see that I have the 140, and I'm loving it, man. Loving it, loving it. Whew. I was sick yesterday, and I'm out here trying to wheelie in 90 degree weather right now, and it doesn't feel good. I always do that, man. Get all that gas. Don't even need it. All right. Let's get out of here, man. Let's go hit some more willies. So guys, I plan on changing these handlebars one of these days. To be honest, they're not that bad to me. I didn't like them at first, but hey. Also, I couldn't find my gloves, man. So I know I'm riding like really unsafe right now. I don't have any gloves, so if I fall, my hands are just gonna be ruined. But we're not gonna think like that. We're just trying to make it home. I just want to come on this gas run and definitely show you guys the 140, man. I've only ridden this thing 3 times so far. This is my 3rd time, and so far I don't even feel like switching to my Makuni. I'm just hoping that the Makuni gives me better throttle control and, you know, just make it overall better. People are still popping fireworks. Air feels good, man. It's really good to be able to cruise now at 50 miles an hour, man, and like my RPMs are not high. This bike always ran a 16T, and that is my preferred sprocket on 125, so it's looking like it's pretty much the same for this 140. I have the right amount of torque, and also I have perfect amount of top end to not be really dogging it out, you know. We all want to go 50 miles an hour consistent. So 16T on any of the stock rears so far that I've seen does pretty well. get away from the cop because it is definitely Willy o'clock. Stay up, stay up. Anybody wanting to know how to do fourth gear wheelies, yank it. Like your life depends on it, and twist the throttle over and over till it stay up. Woo!
Nigga mad cause I'm ghost static. High my mind, I don't walk, I might float back. Gas on the niggas, y'all got broke past. Dead fresh clothes, got tote tags. Feeling much better, how about you? I want a McLaren so I can go fast in it. About to fuck the scene up, yellow flare on the coast. High up the cloud, now I'm about to fuck the streets up. Niggas acting like I'm gonna do nothing with it. Ain't no room for the lane, just a room of bitches. Nigga fuck y'all too and take the rumors with you. I'm feeling too good, too, but no one's at the ceiling. I'm so up, down, that I feel around. Drop the top, hold on now.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, I'm back. So today wasn't like a big riding day or anything. I wasn't out to make a big video, just letting you guys know that I have this thing, man, and I am very happy with what it has become and what it is, man. It is awesome. That's my exhaust wrap smoking off. Don't worry, guys, that is nothing bad. It smells horrible. I smell it every time I start it now. Cannot wait till that thing is finished. My other exhaust wrap did it, but it seemed like not it seems like it didn't do it as much. But this is the 140, guys, as you guys could see, so you don't think that I'm playing. Piranha 140 on this Icebear Champion 125. So it was an easier swap than, like I said, the ZS190 on the Grime clone. This one was way easier. I'm not sure if it's because it was small or if it's because, I don't know, man. It was just easier. So hope you guys like this footage. Hope you guys like the swap that I've done. This is the bike that we're definitely going to be riding all summer on and hopefully years to come, because I really love this bike. And honestly, I'm thinking about becoming a CT collector. So you guys might basically see nothing but CTs on this channel eventually. This was my first prototype, I guess, and you could say this is my first one I've ever owned or driven. So now that I have, I can say that I like it a lot better than any of the other bikes I've ridden, including my favorite, which are scooters. So if you guys like what you're watching, please give me a like and subscribe, and I will be back again rolling with more of these videos, man. Thank you. Peace.